exposure to violence and non-violence came in 1975 after the imposition of the emergency in India. We set up something called Indians for Democracy, and we had a lot of discussion on what would be the values of this Indians for Democracy. In that, one of the criteria for being a member of IFD was that you have to make a commitment to nonviolent action. 1984, I showed up at Ames Hospital within probably half an hour or an hour of Mrs. Gandhi's being brought over there. And already you could see a lot of people beginning to collect outside the hospital. Slogan shouting started by the time I left the hospital. Early next morning when I was returning home, I saw a lot of buses burnt on the roadside. So next day, here we are walking through Lajpat Nagar with this huge crowd of politicians, Farooq Abdullah, Madhu Dandavate, God knows who all were there. And I had taken them past the burnt Gurdwara, and we were going through a narrow lane. All of a sudden, a horde of young men comes running down the lane towards us with knives and swords in their hands. Now, this was absolutely, stunning. The walk suddenly halted, and I grabbed the hands of the two people on my sides, and I said, look, we've got to stand firm together. And just as I was grabbing the hands, Poonam, who was walking behind me, she said, you get back. And so she brought three women in front and said, we'll confront them. But strangely, just as our minds were getting made up to confront this, strangely, a military column came by with a white flag. They were doing a flag march. And as soon as the young men saw the military coming, they just disappeared. So that was kind of a moment of quick thinking. And I can't really say scary, because it was split second respond ki ab to marna hai, lekin marenge. You can't just intuitively rush into non-violence, gets borne out over here.
Yeah.
And when the villagers decided to oppose the forest felling, they consciously chose non-violent resistance as a tactical, strategic way of countering the violence of the woodcutters. There are still, people around who are in their 50s and 60s and late 40s who still remember the Chipko era. And when they come out, and usually they are still out on the streets in protest, they raise these slogans. Ki hum haath nahi uthayenge. Hamla jaisa marzi ho, hum haath nahi uthayenge. These are their, these slogans you can still hear. In our state, for example, there's the Uttarakhand Mahila Manch. They're very clear about this. The first big recognition that the current pattern of development is going to destroy us came with the decision to build a large number of dams in the state. 450 dams were planned across the state.
This is Uttarakhand.
Uttarakhand. To build approach roads, to build the colonies for laborers and so on, a lot of forests were cut down. And that's why women came to the forefront to oppose these dams. Once again, people realize ki bhai ye to bahut badi company hai, sarkar bhi iske piche hai, to hum kaise ladenge inke khilaf? Hamare paas shakti kya hai? That's where non-violence steps in. Okay? The idea is that, achha, wo chipko andolan mein Gaurav Devi ne aise kiya tha, hum bhi dharna karenge. So dharna becomes a very popular mode of opposition. Nature's violence is going to overwhelm human violence. Of course, there will be human violence as people try to hold on to whatever they have. Okay? So it's, we are in for a very difficult time. Pehle bahut hi dukh aur dard hoga, lekin ultimately the human race wants to survive.
Bahut bahut shukriya. Thank you so much.